the no contact rule and why it works. So why does the no contact rule work? I want to tell you that the no contact rule is going to work to get your ex back. It is going to be the secret sauce that does it for you, essentially. What it does for you, for him and your relationship is going to be covered in this video. And I'm going to also cover how to do the no contact rule in a way that will be super easy for you and maybe even fun, so that it actually works and gets him to come crawling back, begging for you to take him back because he misses you so much. What to make sure you avoid, because it will make the no contact period very difficult and screw up everything in getting back together with him, is another thing that I'm going to cover. So the no contact rule at its heart means no communication between you and your ex. That's what it means. No phone calls, no accidentally seeing him, no instant messages, no GChat, no Facebook, no Instagram, no Snapchat, no texting of any kind, no asking a mutual friend to give him a message. Can't do that either. No targeted status updates or social media posts designed to be seen by him. So that's what it means. And I want to now explain what the purpose is, because it's literally going to make you ready to get your ex back and make it much, 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 much more likely. So the purpose is for him, for you, and for your relationship. You're going to have different purposes, and I'm going to explain each one. For him, to have space to miss you, to appreciate the best parts of the relationship, and let go of negativity from the relationship. Men fall in love in your absence. So part of making a man love you or fall back in love with you is giving him lots of space to miss you, appreciate you, and think about how much he wants you back. So now for you, to detox the relationship, gain perspective and clarity, find emotional fulfillment without needing the relationship. You will learn to be okay without looking to him or your relationship to make you feel okay. This will make you way better in relationships for the rest of your life. For the relationship, it's going to hit the reset button, and if you're going to get back with him, start the relationship with a foundation that is going to work well this time and result in a healthy, happy partnership. The reason your relationship ended was because there was something wrong. Maybe it was one thing. Maybe it was a few things. Maybe it was, you know, some buildup of things that happened and made it break. But when you get back together, you want to make sure these problems are solved so that your relationship will actually be stronger than ever. Okay, so let's now discuss the time that you're going to take for no contact to detox. The reason that you need this time to detox is to gain perspective and to heal. So it is so important, because if you want your ex back, you cannot just pursue him right after the relationship ends. The reason is your motivation will be that you feel heartbroken and you just want to feel better again. You'll be looking to him in the relationship to make you feel okay again. And the mindset of needing a relationship will feel needy and desperate to him. And men and human beings are turned off by neediness. Doesn't mean you're a bad person or weak or wrong for feeling this way. Heartbreak is a horrible feeling, and anyone who's felt it obviously wants it to stop. But in the same way that a drug addict has to go through withdrawal in order to detox their system and get clean, we need you to get clean of obsessing over him. And heartbreak is the detox. The no contact rule is your rehab center. Remember this. Heartbreak is the detox, and the no contact rule is your rehab center. It's going to be 30 days, a path to restabilize yourself and your heart and your mind and feel okay again, be at an equilibrium, feel okay, no craving, wanting, you know, needing, no desperation. That is the heart of what kills relationships, and it is not a good place to be at. So next, I want to discuss the no contact steps to success. This is going to give you an organized way to actually take action and change your life in order to get your ex back. So what should you be doing? So I've described the no contact rule. Just do not contact him in any way, shape, or form for 30 days at least. But what should you do? So you should get active, as in work out, you know, be at your best fitness level, take care of yourself, go for walks, be in the sunshine, get vitamin D, get social. So go out with friends, reconnect with people, join clubs that you want to join, or do anything you love, take up a hobby or rekindle a passion, go out on dates even, see what's out there. Not saying you have to, but might as well keep your options open. And that actually makes you more attractive to men in general and your ex, because you will be someone that has options and choice. So the next thing is to take care of yourself. So be nice to yourself. Do not be mean to yourself. The common theme here is going to be do things that will make you feel happier, healthier, and stronger. Think of it like this. While you're getting stronger, he's getting weaker. Think about that. You're going to be getting stronger and he'll be getting weaker. So I want to address a few things, because I know that this is probably, you know, going to make a lot of people say, wait, what if I break no contact, for example? What if I have to respond because he contacts me? I'm going to address all that right now so you know exactly what to do. What if you break no contact? It's okay. Well, it's not okay as in keep doing it, but it's okay in that don't worry, you didn't screw anything up. Just start over. That's it. Erase it from your mind. It's okay. Just start now. Clean slate. Don't dwell on it, though. Don't beat yourself up. Do not be angry at yourself. Don't worry that it's going to ruin things. No, just stop now. Okay? That's all you have to do. What if he contacts me? Okay, you may be asking yourself, what if he contacts me? Oh my God, what do I do? Okay, so you can be civil and you don't have to be cold, but keep it to the minimum response without being outright cold and go on with no contact, unless there's one caveat. The exception to this is if he is clearly gushing with an apology, making it beyond a shadow of a doubt that he is sorry, he loves you so much, oh my God, then that's different. If he's literally pouring his heart to you and like practically pleading with you and apologizing, then you can talk to him, and that's a totally different scenario. And obviously then you'll get what you want, but even so, be calm and centered. Never be reactive and highly emotional, because it'll make him remember why he didn't want to be with you. So next, how long should no contact last? I've mentioned this, but I'll say it again, 30 days. What if he's the father of your child? Okay, so there's no way to avoid seeing him, obviously, but the principles of the no contact rule remain the same. The conversation should only focus on your child together. Every other topic is off limits. So now I want to discuss big no contact mistakes to avoid. Big no contact mistake number one is to use drugs or alcohol to escape. Breakups suck. They're horrible. There's no way around it. But if you use alcohol, drugs, or other substances as a way of masking the pain and hiding from it, all you're doing is pushing the pain deeper inside you. Treat the no contact period like a detox of your body after the breakup and your mind. You have a lot of unpleasant emotions to get through, and by giving yourself time away from him, you're giving your body time to process the pain naturally rather than hurting yourself more. The next big mistake, thinking about your ex constantly. During the no contact period, you're allowing the toxicity of the breakup to naturally work its way out of your body. This means that you'll be physically and emotionally processing the pain of the breakup. And of course, you'll be thinking about your ex a lot during that time, like wondering if he still loves you, whether he's seeing someone else, or if he even thinks about you. This is actually counterproductive because it reinforces this obsession and doesn't let you heal. So stop, try to catch yourself. And as I mentioned earlier, be social, hang out with friends, occupy your time, and focus on fixing things about your life that you can control. So the real reason that no contact works is because you process the breakup. So I'm trying to kind of explain how this all connects for you. You process the breakup, you cut off contact with him, right? And when you do this, you give yourself time and space to process the breakup and move on. Very important. When you prove to yourself that you can live your life without him, you instantly become way more attractive to him. That's the key here. Think about it this way. When you first got together, you weren't begging him to be with you and feeling like you were unable to live your life without him. No, you were living life the way you wanted to live your life, right? He was a nice addition to your life that made it better. That's what you want to always want and go for. The next reason it's amazingly effective is because it gives him room to miss you. I've mentioned this before, but I'll say it again. There are tons of negative feelings after a breakup for both parties, and most of the time in the days following it, all he can think about are the negatives from your relationship. So give it time and give him room to miss you. The biggest takeaway, no contact means no contact. But it's an active 30 days. So remember how I compared it to a drug rehab. What do you do when you go to a drug rehab? You do things actively to make it not bad and not happen again, not relapse. right? So how do you not relapse into some bad pattern that will affect your outcome, aka you won't get your ex back if you don't change? You need to get used to being okay without him or the relationship. Learning to feel okay on your own will literally, ironically, indirectly save your relationship. Learning to feel okay without needing him or a relationship to make you feel okay is actually not just for no contact. It is such an important relationship skill to have for the rest of your life, not just to get him back. So always remember that. Learning to feel okay without needing him or a relationship to make you feel okay is not just for no contact. This is a relationship skill to have for the rest of your life, and it will make men feel much more inclined to be with you. Trust me. So I really hope that this helps. If you have any questions at all, please do leave them in the comments. I love responding and I love getting questions. And if you liked this video, I would love if you gave it a thumbs up. And for more, you can check out the article that goes into super detail about this no contact and exactly how to do it. It's actually in the description, so you can click on the link there. And then finally, check out VixenDaily.com for more love advice so you never have to be confused by men or relationships again. Bye.